sports. It's in the game.
Slot on the street, bro. That's awesome.
Takes us to the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California. Who said the crowds wouldn't embrace football being back in L.A.? You certainly couldn't tell that by what we saw a few moments ago. These folks are pumped up as their Rams get set to do battle with Drew Brees and the New Orleans Saints. Greg Zuerlein, the Rams kicker, approaches, kicks it off. And here we go from Los Angeles to return it, Alvin Kamara. And nice work on the return as he'll start to drive just past the 30-yard line.
Yo, Saints fan, bro.
Line of scrimmage with 31 now on first and 10. And tough going there, so he'll only get it up to about the 31. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping is the defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Give him 2 yards on that play, and all of a sudden here it's third down. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. He's got a man open, it's Cannon Meredith. Not able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. His first catch, good for 14 there and a first down.
Sit out, Carolina.
On first and 10, here's Breeze. This is a catch by Ted Ginn. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 34. Now Breeze again. And it pops through. The collision there. Jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. So he can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from the
owner,
but you're
going
to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Well, you know a coach said that, right?
Not an actual player.
Bro, that's why I be sad. Madden be wigging on these picks, bro.
20 yards.
I'm not sure if this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So, second catch on the drive. He may not be a primary guy, but they definitely want him involved, don't they?
Yeah, absolutely. This early, the opening drive, as you said, two catches. So, if they can get him going in the passing game, that should open up his running game, too. 6 yards on the pickup, and it's a second down. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area. But they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
They give him about 4 on the play, but he's marked short, so it'll be third and about the length of the football.
And you get that first down. Okay, good goal line stands, bro. Get the field goal, bro.
And that's going to lead him to fourth down. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. On the keeper, it's Breeze. And he will have the first
stay right there.
He's brought down at the 3. They only get a hard-fought yard, but that's all they needed. It pays off the decision to go for it. First and goal.
That nigga don't play for us no more. I can't believe we gave up Mark Ingram, bro.
Good first step there defensively, but
we on that.
On the doorstep, so maybe
we on that, bro. Cause havoc down here, bud.
You can darn near lay down near the end zone and get in. Give me my best power running play with my best back right now.
Try to bow up once more. Now this time, Breeze will throw. Got a man open. It's Thomas. It's a touchdown for the
Orioles.
Michael Thomas, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Saints have taken the early lead. Lutz now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Goff will lead the Rams up here first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
Whoa, spread him out.
Out of the gun, Goff. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And it drops down incomplete.
Kill.
Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
The improv, they're good for 9, and now they'll be looking at a third and short, third and one.
Well, it looked like a quick hitter, okay. A three-step drop. Clutch. But when it's not there, okay. What do you do? He elects to try and escape through the massive bodies up the middle, and he does so and picks up positive yardage.
Now the first carry here for Todd Gurley.
Come on, Gurley.
Lose yardage here, going down back at the 28.
I know, right? That Calvin Jordan, though, bro.
Brings up fourth. An ideal start defensively. They already have the touchdown. Now they get the stop.
Just I'm like they drew it up on the
chalkboard. Does that sound dated?
Gurley gonna do his thing right now, bro.
Guy, grease board, heck, computer, exactly what you want, though. Score on your first drive, stop them on the first drive defensively.
And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They are going for it. Goff. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. A good roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert. He's going to loft one deep left side here. Looking for Cooks, and it's intercepted.
I know, Burns. God damn.
They didn't show patience there, did they? Just down the score, they come out firing right away and compound
things. He's slow. He's starting on his own, bro.
They put their defense in a really tough spot. So after the INT, it's Breeze. Oh, look at Thomas wide open. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. This drive's starting off on the right foot, 18 yards. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
I put that, put the shoulder pads on him, bro.
Ball pops.
Come on.
Incomplete. From the 21, it's second and 10. Back to the air on second down. It's Breeze.
Set season. Set season. Right it up.
Michael Brockers.
My bad, Breeze. I didn't mean to do you like that, bro.
And it'll be a loss of about 8. On third and long, it's Breeze.
Appreciate it.
That'll be tipped and intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And these guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line.
Yo.
Well, it's third and long, and you've got a few different ways to play it offensively. But this is not the type of offense that's going to wave the white flag. They're going to keep chucking it. And this time, it results in an interception.
Now the Rams offense, they work their way back on the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. This will be the first red zone opportunity now for the Rams. They have a first and 10 at the 13-yard line. From the gun, here's Goff. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
Now on second down, this is Gurley. And they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Throwing on third, gone. And it's caught, and he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off.
And he will score! Touchdown, LA! Jared Goff taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Rams are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Sirlein connects on the extra point, and we are tied at 7. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. We're back to the City of Angels after this timeout. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Caught by the tight end Watson. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Here we go. One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Oh, did he hang on to it? He did on the dive. Nice grab. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs.
I know a retirement ceremony is a rocking chair is often one of the major gifts, but don't give this guy one just yet. He may be plus 30, but my goodness, how about that effort?
Yeah, he's not that old. Hey, I'm on the wrong side of 32.
You okay? You feeling all right?
I'll be all right.
Okay, good.
I just need some chocolate and a box of tissues. Breeze again here on 2nd and 10. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's 3rd down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
A big 3rd down conversion with a gain of 28.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that.
And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. Aaron Donald in there to sack him for a loss of 6. On 2nd down, here's Breeze. Wide open receiver complete. And he's down inside the 5 at the 4 before he's out of bounds. A good pickup there of 22.
But it certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense. And guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle. You put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate. Now that's the defense that they were looking for, being able to get extra bodies to the point of attack to deal with the big guy carrying the ball. You really don't want to be in a position where it's a one-on-one tackle with him.
And a stoppage here, a timeout before this 3rd down play takes place. As they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. The Ram fans in this old stadium on their feet. 3rd and goal. Now Breeze, looking for Thomas, he's got him. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas, as the first half is winding down, and the Saints are able to cash in for 6. Lutz now to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. And the Rams now coming out on the field. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Just get out of there.
It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. A final shot before break here. Goff going up top. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. 2 quarters down. 2 still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So now here are the Rams as their offense comes back out. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. We'll get this complete to cover.
Oh, Peyton! Come here!
He's all the way down inside the 35. Give him 30 yards there.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about
the
field position?
Don't do it. Don't do that. Don't play that weak defense.
He picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
Now Goff on first down. He's going to float this one deep right side. Oh, he had 6.
I could have caught that, bro. Come on. Oh, had zone with this Madden, bro.
Well, that certainly looked like
bro, he really hit my legs. I really put white, bro. Oh, man,
I switched
the play up.
At worst, you open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40.
I know. I'm looking at him. All right.
So Goff, he'll try to refocus after the sack. The Rams now set up with a tough one, a third and long.
Hey, 76.
DC. A shotgun snap for Goff. And Kurtz has it over the middle. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. It'll be a gain of 12, but it will also lead to fourth down.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get...
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And he fires one.
Come on, I think he's staying with me, coach.
Picked off by Eli Apple, and he's able to get it back.
Eli Apple ain't doing that with me, coach.
Well, we have a second, Charles.
He jumping with a tight end, bro.
In the Super Bowl, getting the 37-31 victory over KC in the AFC title game. Great game, but the Patriots.
You know nobody believes in him.
Yeah, right. They're playing that underdog card, but I thought it was funny because after the game, they asked Tom Brady, "Were you guys just trying to use that for your own motivation?" He said, "No comment." Because they know they're not the underdog.
They know it, but when you've been that great for this long,
you need something.
You've got to find something different. And Tom Brady, I've got to give him credit. Somehow he made his team buy that and believe in it when no one else in the country did. And I think it really started with their first playoff game this year when the Chargers came to town.
Yeah.
I know I picked the Chargers against them. A lot of people picked the Chargers. They took that as, well, no one believes in us. And everyone thinks we're not as good. They were just wrong about that part as we were wrong about the Chargers beating them.
Breeze to throw on second down. Looking for
give me that. Call him. I hate when they do that, man. Come on, stop waiting.
But with that incompletion, let's look back, Charles, to the NFC title game. We had two
excellent conference championship games,
but on the NFC side, the Rams winning in overtime thanks to Greg Zuerlein. He had 2 huge kicks, but that was really overshadowed because afterwards, obviously, everyone talking about the no call.
Yeah, and we should be talking about Legatron, a 48-yarder to get them to overtime, the 57-yarder to win it in overtime. He should be the guy who should be exalted right now, but you're exactly right. Mikel Roby Coleman's hit on Tommy Lee Lewis in regulation, when I saw it live, that was a bang-bang play.
Bringing that blitz,
turned out,
bro,
it was definitely a missed call.
Look,
plus, they missed on the contact on it as well. So if you're a Saints fan, you are very, unexcited about the Rams advancing to the Super Bowl, but I still don't want pass interference to become a reviewable call. The game flow is paramount to me. Let's not slow it down anymore than it already is.
Yeah, it could be a slippery slope, then you start doing it with everything.
Right? Next thing you know, we'll be reviewing holding. Mm-hmm. And by the way, you can probably call holding just about every play in the NFL.
There's gone. He's letting it fly for Colts. And that one
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield.
Quit,
whether you're playing man or zone, eventually that becomes man on man, and you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Second and 10, Goff again. Now he'll dump it underneath.
Oh, when they do that, bro.
And he's tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Goff on first down. And that'll be caught by Cup.
Come on.
And now look at this. Big game, but a fumble. The
Saints
say they have it, and they do.
Oh, my God.
Seen this before.
So Brees gonna lead the Saints up here first and 10
bro.
At their own 17 yard line.
My YouTube show
Yen has it complete. Runs through the contact.
Project clean walk home. He fumbled, bro. He put the ball down, bro.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
That's a weak guy's game, though.
Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Back now in Los Angeles. It's the Saints. They'll be looking to expand their lead here. They've got the football as we start the fourth.
I'm gonna add, brother. If you win, we got to play again, bro. I like the way how you playing with the Sun.
Now Brees throwing on second down. And he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game changer there in the second half. Instead, it's third down.
Come on, bro. Well, that was a pit, right? Come on, stop playing with me, man.
You've got to protect it, and he's taking chances putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 17 yards on the pickup there, and also a first down. Shotgun now for Brees. And look at this. They get the turnover.
It's wrong. It's wrong. They owe me. They robbed me, man. They owe me.
Tight game of the fourth.
All you talk about is taking care of the football, and especially with a lead here in the fourth quarter. Turning it over, now the door is open for the opposition.
Just in general, when you're passing in the fourth quarter with a lead, no matter at what point, you got to be super careful.
Got to be careful, and sometimes you can be so careful that you end up running yourself into an error.
Do that, baby. They go play action here on first down. He's letting it fly for Cooks. An incomplete.
Cooks can do that, bro. That's Marcus Williams, bro.
Second down.
It's Marcus Williams. You got respect
this
that
defense
man, bro.
Was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Now gone. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
Trying to erase that deficit all at once. One big shot. He took it. Unfortunately for him, incomplete.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete as well.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield as it turned out.
He's
couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage was way too tight. Unable to find anyone
open. One score down, here we go.
He did more. He gave up a touchdown though, bro. He gave up the touchdown.
Gotta try it here. He's back to throw.
He gave up the touchdown, bro.
Going up top for Cup. And that is incomplete. No luck for the Rams. times as they fail here they on fourth down.
Me, bro.
And the
Saints
will have the
so
football back.
Me
now
right
the
now.
Saints, they trot their offense out here right now, clinging to a one-score lead, Charles, and I think operating within that four-minute offense with a little less than 4 minutes to go applies here, right?
It certainly does, and that means the playbook is still wide open. But you are a little bit more careful about what you're calling. You want plays, they're going to gain yardage, how would you say it, consistently, right? You don't need the big shots downfield, but make sure the clock continues to run. Pile up the first down, and the goal, end the game with your quarterback kneeling down at the end, and you still have the lead.
A hit as he throws there, incomplete. He was trying to get it that time to 10 again, and that'll bring up second down.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the party to develop.
Okay, man.
Another time, second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Bro, we got this on YouTube, man. YouTube, thank you. Thank you. Ain't no way going on, bro. That's the end of bro's career right there, bro.
It's Breeze. Oh, look at Thomas wide open. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line.
My whole YouTube know you're a fluke, bro. Oh, God.
Now he's got a first down here.
Like,
he's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down when his way worked.
That's crazy,
doesn't matter whether they scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
4 yards on the pickup, and it'll be a second down.
But it's tough to be a defender in today's NFL because there's so many things to account for in today's passing game, including the back sneaking out of the backfield. Not quite as bad as a turkey bowl where you have that center-eligible stuff. But still, a lot of guys.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Ted Ginn, 26 yards. And the Saints add on to their lead. And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him. Let him do the rest.
You know, he probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his rack, right? RAC.
Run after catch. And he loves that. And he's going to carry that in at contract time.
That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. The Rams offense now making their way out to take over. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. A really good pickup of 28 yards. On first down, it's gone. And that is incomplete. Cooper Kupp was his intended target. That'll bring up second down.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit and they may have to change accordingly.
On second and 10, Goff. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
We just saw another example of really good defensive football, which has led to the cushion that they have in this game. Got to him once again.
It's making me mad, bro, because
they've set the tone. They
are wigging me, bro.
They
are so wigging me right now.
A big play to start the drive, but nothing since. Gone. He's going to float this one deep right side.
Come on.
And incomplete, almost intercepted. Great shot of picking it off in the end zone.
Yo, I'm done with Madden for the season, bro. I'll retire Madden, bro. It's three fucking niggas right there, bro. Oh, God,
bro.
Like, look at this shit ass defense he playing, bro.
That would be a big play.
Try to lay one up deep.
Thank you.
Inside the 10.
Thank you.
Cooks, 54 yards, and the Rams have got this back to a one-score game.
Thank you, bro.
Zerline good with a PAT,
And now things get
I'm
a bit
getting
more
the ball
interesting
off,
here
play
in
defense.
This
I wasn't even going to let me on defense, bro.
Zerline out now to kick this one away. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You got plenty
it's
of time
to run, y'all.
Defensively,
it's not throwing the ball.
You have three timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have a full conversation.
Put that ball down, little bro.
You tell them, here's the situation.
Put that ball down, little bro.
Their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it three times and punt it, you got another thing coming.
Yeah, and then by the way, also the two-minute warning in place. So
appreciate
look
it. Game
at
time.
This. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Akeem Talib.
Game time.
And he's gonna take
we got a game
now,
bro.
To the 37.
We got a game now, bro. And I got to add this man, bro.
So that right there was his second pick, but keep in mind, this is a guy who once had a rare three interception game in his career.
So what are you saying that getting two in a game?
Tell him start hang. Tell him start hang.
You know he wants a third again.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here? Or is it just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
Now a desperation. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Okay.
That's a nice job
I'm dying,
to bro. Get a piece of the football.
I'm dying, Madden, bro.
The air, and then it's the tip
I can, you too. I can't do it no more, bro.
To react to it and pull in the interception.
Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to
you
throw.
Too. You too. I can't do it no more, bro.
Down,
this man right it. Here, this Madden, his internet connection, his defense, his offense.
Like, they have about five or six plays per game that they
I can't do it no more, bro. I just can't do it. It's over with, bro. Oh, I'm retiring Madden, bro.
To make a big play, that's gonna hurt.
Time out, bro. I'm retiring Madden, bro. EA, I'm sorry, bro. But you got the 50 glitches.
And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down.
Got to fish this shit, bro. This don't make no sense. And then, bro, wide open by himself, like,
yeah, the Rams are going to go ahead and take another timeout. As he'll get it, we're still a minute 20 left.
I bet Steven Wonder can play this shit blind, bro. Oh, God, bro.
First and 10. Breeze to throw.
Okay, we got another chance, YouTube.
Oh, what? Picked off by Akeem Talib.
Thank you, YouTube. Thank you, YouTube.
He goes left side. And he will score. Touchdown, LA. Charles, we've seen him target.
Come on, bro. They can't win the GOAT, bro.
Maybe they went to that well too many times there.
Yeah, it's so difficult to determine how many times is too many because how many times have we seen a team go and play and say, until they stop us, we'll keep going. But they got stopped on that.
Oh, I
tell
you, too. You know, I love Madden, bro. I'm a Madden guy, bro.
Point there, up and good. And, partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild fourth quarter.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it's just.
I want it, bro. He really tried me like he really wanted the game, bro. Like, who the fuck? Bro, stop playing the Saints, bro. You just really tried to breathe, bro. Like, you want another pick? All right.
Back to throw, Breeze.
Oh, he want
to
run the screen.
Screen now to Kamara. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45.
Oh, he
want to
run. He want to be heroic. He want to look, bro. He want to be heroic.
First down.
Now you're right on the edge of field goal range. You still got time, but get up to the line of scrimmage and get set.
Thank you.
And this is going to be intercepted.
Thank you.
Picked off by a team.
Thank you. Nigga. Come on, stop playing with me, man.
At the 40-yard line.
He made a pretty little bad, bro. He called himself a Saints fan, bro. Why not drive it down the field and put it in the field goal range? Tells you how much better teams have gotten at throwing the football. If you go all the way back to 1960, get off my stick, bro. Get off me. Guys have gotten four interceptions or more in a game. I mean, most recently since 2000. Not once. Not three times.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40.
They don't want me to be great, bro. Like, I'm trying to be great here, bro.
Goff now to throw.
Touchdown.
Going for the deep ball. That's caught inside the 20. And that's a touchdown as they've broken our tie here in the final minute of the fourth. Might be seeing that one on the
quit the game, little bro. Tonight, the home run ball on the fucking goal, bro.
Take the lead.
There's nothing like being aggressive, preaching that to your team, and then following through. All the way through. Go ahead and throw one more.
What kind of defense? I'm playing a little kid or something, bro. Got to be playing a little kid or something. Did you not see his defense?
Take a 7-point lead. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And with time a factor here, right, late, he'll just take a knee and they'll start things out at the 25. The Saints coming out now to take the field. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, bro, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation.
It's fake. It's fake. It's fake.
And he is
three niggas coming
in for the score. And now they can tie the game in the first stages with an extra point.
No, it wins, bro. And he's going for the two, bro. He going for the two.
For two and a possible win.
He going for the two, bro.
As this crowd rises to make things difficult. They'll look to throw. And it is caught.
He going for points and get the fuck out of here, bro. This is fake. Bro, what is you doing? It's fake.
This is fielded a couple yards.
Oh my god. Oh my lord. It is fake. What he's doing? 22 yard line.
I rest my case, bro. Oh god, bro. I'll rest my case.
YouTube. What in the world?
You're thinking two plays. One to get yourself in position for the second one. Whether you're able to get into field goal range or you have to try another deep pass, another Hail Mary. But you're trying to get the first one to a receiver, get out of bounds, and give yourself a chance to set things up for an easier shot.
See if they can do it. Might be easier said than done. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
That don't mean nothing, bro.
That's
gay, bro. You gay for that, bro. Oh my god, this is so fucking gay, bro.
It's a touchdown.
Bro, he went for the fucking two, bro. And I'm like, at well-known coverage, bro. Like, you know, bro. See, this shit fake, bro. I feel like I'm being clowned right now, bro. By Mickey Yoder, bro. Like, bro.
So they throw the pick six.
No,
but
oh my god, bro.
As this one's in the air. Short kick. One of the up middle take it now. And they'll be set up with good field position here as he gets this up over the 40-yard line.
And when you're facing a deficit on the scoreboard, you're just looking for something to get you right back into the game.
Over the bubble to the end zone too, bro.
They got it with that big return.
One last throw here for Goff. He's gonna let it fly.
Oh, oh, the goal! They start weighing me. It's my turn. It's my turn. This is my turn.
And now the decision is to go for two. A gutsy call in this.
My turn,
bro. Is your ball
they got made
right
the two.
One final shot. They'll look to throw.
And this is incomplete. So no miracles here on the final play. And
it's bro, I'm putting the game on YouTube, bro.
Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the
very end. He went in zone.
Couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular.
Oh my God, bro!
Exactly right. They took us down to the last.
Bro.